Borchardt, and this is your Marijuana Money Minute. We are in the throes of earnings season, and in the midst of all this information, the broader market fell terribly. Equities slid over 800 points one day as the bond market signaled recessionary fears. And it wasn't much better over in the cannabis sector either. Let's go over these earnings. We're going to hit the highlights. Canopy Growth stock dropped over 10% after the company announced its first quarter had net losses of over $1 billion. That way dwarfed last year's losses of $91 million. The loss was attributed to a non-cash charge of $1.2 billion in Canopy's extinguishing warrants related to the Constellation Brands investment. Cinnabis Global reported that its second quarter net revenue rose 78% to $25 million from last year's $4.1 million. So, sounding good, right? But then they delivered a net loss of $18.5 million. Now, Cinnabis had said that it expected its net cannabis revenue to be in the range of $10 to $12 million, but the actual net cannabis revenue came in at only $7.2 million. Charlotte's Web revenue grows 45% to $25 million over last year's $17.2 million. Sounding good. Unfortunately, the net income fell to $2.2 million from last year's $3.7 million. Now, Tilray's second quarter revenue increased 371% to $45 million. Sounding good. But the company reported a net loss of $35.1 million, and that's compared to a loss of $12.8 million last year. MedMen reported that its revenue rose 15% sequentially to $42 million, and that's not counting pending acquisitions. But the company said it also had to amend its deal with Gotham Green to reflect the company's much lower stock price. Now, one of the brightest earnings for the week came from Trulieve, which reported revenue of $57.9 million. That was an increase of 30% sequentially. They also reported net income, not a net loss, net income of $57 million, so congratulations to them. Bad news for CanTrust again. After the market closed on Friday, the company said it received a report from Health Canada saying that its manufacturing facility in Vaughan, Ontario, had been rated non-compliant with certain regulations, and that stock dropped over 25% on that news. And that's it for this week. I'm Deborah Borchardt reporting from Times Square for the Green Market Report.